Hello everyone and welcome to another episode of Channel Fire Brawl, where this week we're going to get it done with Ashiok Dreamrender. I've had a little bit of success with this deck on stream, and by a little I really do mean a little bit. Milling people out is tricky, but we're going to do our damnedest here to make it happen. Ashiok, obviously, as a 3-drop commander, as a Planeswalker commander, and as a card that will mill 20 cards if left unchecked, is very, very good. And you can get people who, you know, crack their Fabled Passages into this card. But it, I mean, you need a little support. Needs a lot, well, I say a little bit, a lot. So we're playing more or less every mill card. Sorry, this we're playing Garuda. So this I can't get rid of this companion slot here. Sorry about that. Just everything that mills cards, basically, we're playing. Whether it's playable or not, it's in there. Don't even worry about it. Was the other one, Thought Collapse here as well. And then just a bunch of removal as well. A bunch of removal, a bunch of counter spells, hand disruption, what have you, ways to maybe gain a little bit of life. We do have some other non-mill finishes just in case. You know, sort of break glass in case of emergency type thing. Garuda's in there as well. But really, at the end of the day, we're trying to mill out our opponent. A couple of sweet things we can do. Scheming Symmetry means that if we cast Scheming Symmetry with Ashiok, they just don't get to search. If we cast it without Ashiok and then mill them, they don't get the thing that they put on top of the library, which is pretty sweet. Also, stuff like Thief of Sanity, those the cards you don't pick, they go to the graveyard. So it kind of mills them for three almost every time it hits, which is important. Also, if the game goes really long, we can reshuffle our library. So there's plenty of like there are a lot of sweet things going on in this list. Is it very good? It is not. No, it is not a very good deck. But look, we'll give it a crack. We'll see how it goes, and hopefully, mill some fools out here with old Ashiok here, my good friend. Well, I say my good friend. Ashiok just the voice lines, the whole no head and horns instead. I mean. Nightmare is a very apt word. Sculptor of Fears. Yes, exactly. Very, very well named, this character. Anyway, quick, of course, ad read, channelfireball.com, the place to go to buy and sell cards. Buy list promotion going on right now, so make sure you go and check that out. In addition to CFB Pro, if you're sick of watching dumb videos that don't make any sense at all and, you know, largely piloted by an idiot, you can go instead and watch stuff on CFB Pro where none of that is true. Starting at $9.99 a month or $9.98, 1 cent off if you use the night coupon code. So go and get across that and become a better Magic player today, my friends, by doing that. And well, I mean, if you want to become a better Magic player, maybe do it tomorrow. Go and get CFB tomorrow. I mean, it's fine. Just for now, just watch this one. You're gonna have a good time. I'm gonna meal people out. You're gonna have a great time. You're gonna enjoy it. Anyway, all right, let's get to the games. All right, let's get it going here. Now the good news is. We're not going to play against any Yorion decks. It's not possible to have an 80 card list in this format. You can't have a Yorion as a companion in this format, so that's good. This hand kind of sucks. I think we can do better. We just want like a 2 drop, right? Ooh, yeah, very good. Okay, beautiful. Yeah, keep this for sure. Arcane Signet turn 2. Got Ashiok turn 3, even with our tap lands. Yep, I don't know what I want yet, so I'm not going to cast this. Like, I don't know if I draw a land next turn that I don't want to land with this. Yeah, so this is fine. So we play this, play that. And now we can cast. We can play Temple with a little bit more information. What are we up against here? Sorin. So Sorin not at his best in Historic Brawl. Very, very powerful. I feel like I've been beaten pretty horribly by Sorin decks in the past. I don't know. I guess that's actually quite annoying against our Ashiok here. Quite annoying indeed. I guess we'll just still play Ashiok though. Play Ashiok. Alright. Mill him out a little bit. My volume's turned off, so that's not an issue. I was listening to a little bit of Strauss before. Eagle-eyed viewers will have noticed that. Do we want a Brazen Borrower? No. Probably not. If they... They'll probably attack Ashiok. But I think we've got a decent turn next turn. We can cast Into the God Eternals. Your lack of fear. Man, Ashiok's voice lines just give me the heebie-jeebies. I'm gonna cast Thought Erasure, and then I'm probably just gonna cast Heartless Act. Let's have a look at what they're working with here. Okay, just a lot of nonsense. Sacrifice a creature. Okay, well that's gonna be good against our God Eternals, but like Oh, man, I don't care about any of these cards. I guess the worst case scenario for us is they cast Toll of the Invasion, get rid of our End of the God Eternals, and then cast the Spawn of Mayhem. But they're probably just going to cast the Spawn of Mayhem next turn. Do we take this? I don't care about the murder. I don't care about this stuff. Like, we're just not going to keep creatures alive, so that's fine. So it's between these two. How much do we want to protect our hand? Let's get rid of the Toll of the Invasion. So now we can cast Narset. That seems reasonable. Yeah. So they can kill Ashiok, but that's fine. We can just cast him next turn. Okay, 4. And activate Narset. Hopefully get something good here. I have just the trick. And a... take Liliana, sure. Liliana. Alright, we go 1-1. This is fine. Not too worried. Like, we've got an answer to the Order of Midnight with the Heartless Act. We've got an answer to the Spawn of Mayhem with the End of the God Eternals. We can maybe take control of their Dreadhorde Invasion. Let's see. All right, Knight of the Ebon Legion. That was the fresh draw. So now they're not doing anything for the rest of their turn. I guess they can't, right? Wait, they can just attack and then cast this. I guess they want to kill the Ashiok. Yeah, never mind. All right, Command Zone, please. So we can just cast him again next turn. Overwhelmed Apprentice. All right. Well, let's see what we get off Narset here. I would have preferred a land, I think. Ooh, Cry. Sure. Sometimes the game plays itself. All right. Easy game. Let's get rid of all them. And we'll just play this. We'll play this because, I mean, we could keep up Heartless Act in case they draw a land. Ooh. Drown Seekers is very, very strong. Drown Seekers is extremely strong in this deck. But the thing is, if we take it, we're not... yeah, so I'll do this, and then I'll... like, I can cast Liliana next turn. And then draw it the turn after Bleeding Edge ends. I mean, we're never keeping creatures alive, but I don't really care about that too much. So let's pay 2, play this, and just chump block. Forever. I guess actually they can attack Liliana for 4 next turn. We draw a card off of that. Maybe this is bad. Maybe this is bad. Drown Secrets are so strong though. Yeah. Alright. Drawing a land would be sweet here. We can take control of that Dreadhorde Invasion. Yep. That's fine. Now what do they do? They're stuck on lands, like, it's rough. It's a rough position for them to be in, stuck on lands like this. Or it's sweet Oblivion is not what we want. Do we just enter the God Eternals? Yeah. Enter God Eternals, target this, target you, and we gain 4. Right. Yeah, nice. And Liliana's Triumph, sure. So sacrifice this, draw cards. And now they can make the sacrifice this as well. But I mean, again, that's totally fine. Totally, totally fine. Right, Spawn of Mayhem, yep. We've got a Heartless Act for that. Okay, here's Evolving Wilds. So, let's go. We've got 6 mana. So we'll go upstairs with Liliana. Drown Secrets. Sweet Oblivion, target you, target you. Okay, we need to also exile their graveyard at some point too. Let's go and get an island. And we'll... no attacks. Maybe we could have attacked there, but I mean, that's not how we're winning, so. All right, so we can kill the Spawn of Mayhem with the Heartless Act. And they've still got Murder plus the Undercity's Embrace. So if they cast the Undercity's Embrace, I'm just going to... I'll Heartless Act in response. Sorin, okay. To give something Death Touch and Lifelink? To give the 2-2 Death Touch and Lifelink? Doesn't really do anything, though. To give the Spawn of Mayhem? Yeah. Right, I'm just Heartless Act in response, I guess. I mean, it doesn't matter when we do it. Destroy target creature with no counters on it. And away it goes. Okay. And our opponents had enough, yeah. I think just they just stuck on lands. Like, stuck on lands. We were eventually going to win with probably with Liliana. So, all right, doesn't count. Doesn't count. We haven't milled anyone yet. All right, let's try again here. The aim is to actually have someone draw from an empty library or concede with an empty library or like, yeah. Not just like, oh, I'm probably going to lose. Oh, we need to actually get them to the point where they are dead. All right, I don't like this hand. Especially on the draw, on the play, I don't like it. I don't like this one much more either, but Drowned Secrets is probably the best mill enabler we have here. So we'll keep it and hopefully draw a couple of lands here against Nylea. All right. Perfect. Okay, so Drowned Secrets. Yeah, Drowned Secrets puts us ahead from the beginning here, having all of our... I think all of our cards have like kicker mill two, which is very strong, right? All right. It continues. And when you're playing the deck, you want to do Ashiok last. Like activating Ashiok is the last thing you want to do because their ability exiles the graveyard, right? So you don't want to Ashiok first and then mill a bunch of other cards and leave them with, I don't know, an Uro or a whatever in the bin. Alright, does this do anything? Wait, upstairs, okay. So we can just answer that. We just bounce it, actually. That doesn't seem too bad. Like, that kind of sets them back. Let's go mill you for another six. Maybe playing the Midnight Clock would actually be better there to continue to develop our mana, actually. Bounce this. Yeah. Now I think about it, I think that would have been a little better. Because the Ashok isn't a huge threat. Like, even if they play a creature, they'll probably just go downstairs for a card with it, though. Anyway, alright. Well, we're halfway there. It's turn four and we're halfway there, so it's looking good. Alright, Nylea, sure. This isn't good. Alright, so Midnight Clock, mill him for two. And then Merfolk Secret Keeper, mill him for another two. And then we'll activate Ashiok's ability to... I mean, eight cards a turn is a lot. Like, they're down to 22 in library. We've got another 6-10 coming next turn as well. That's if we don't draw a land. This card's also pretty strong. You get a set. Oh dear, Cogler. Okay, well, Cogler's going to put a real. Oh no, Cogler destroys our Drowned Secrets as well. Oh, you do hate to see that. You really do hate to see that. We just have to murder the Cogler. Yeah, we just have to kill it. So let's go Wall of Lost Thought. Yeah, Wall of Lost Thought. Mill you, because otherwise we lose our Drowned Secrets. They're on 19. I think we're going to get them. Mill you in for another four. And then do this. And I'm just going to do this main phase. There's no heroic intervention in the format just yet, but I'm just not interested. Like, they're not going to cast anything else that I want to kill more than this Cogler, and we can't let it attack. All right, 11 cards left in library. We may get there here. We may get there. So 10 cards. This is four... this is another four that's... So if we draw a land, we can get them to two. Two cards left. Ooh. If they go downstairs with Vivian... No, upstairs, okay. I think we got a good chance here. We've got a really good chance. Negate, all right. So, I guess we just say go. Oh, actually, hang on. Oh, man. This is the disgusting thing about having Planeswalker commanders. Look at this. Command zone. So, mill four. Right? And now, cast it again. Right? That's gross. Oh, my goodness. I feel extremely dirty. Because this is Xaxes. They got six. This mills them to four. Right? And then the Ashiok mills them to another four. Oh my goodness, gross. So disgusting. Milled them for exacties with all of our mana tapped. Oh mate, I don't know if you love to see it or you hate to see it, but you definitely do see it at least. Oh, getcha. Oh, wow. Okay, well, we did the thing. We did the thing. We did the thing. So all we need to have happen is for them to have no interaction and for us to have Drowned Secrets in our opening hand and for us to draw pretty well as well. This sucks, but I'll keep it. I'll keep it. Yeah. Keep this. So we'll play this on turn one, and then we'll play these two on turn two and draw. I really, really want to draw the Drowned Secrets. Drowned Secrets actually should be our commander, really. If only. If only. Okay, five color nonsense here. So let's go. Yeah, so watch this. We go Scheming Symmetry. We both go and get something. I'll get Drowned Secrets. I like how the arena is like, you should get this card. You should take this card. It's right at the top of the pile. All right, so Drowned Secrets, and whatever they get, right, we get to mill over with our Overwhelmed Apprentice. So these are the big brain plays. These are that high-level, pro-level plays that you love to see. Now, of course, I believe I made an error in the beginning of the thing. Yeah, so it didn't come up here. I think it Risen Reef. No, not anymore. Seems fine. So I think at the beginning of the video, I said that Ashiok prevents them from searching the scheme, but they do, because we have to control. They have to control the ability for it to. Let's get in there, mate. Take one. Ooh. So this shuts off abilities that. Spells and abilities the opponents control. This is obviously a spell that we control, so it doesn't work like I said it did in the intro, unfortunately. I realized that while refreshing myself on Ashiok's flavor text, I guess you could call it. Alright, so how badly do we need to leave up Folio of Fancies? They get back Fires of Invention. You know, I kind of want to let them have the Tameo, to be honest. I kind of want to let them have the Tameo, because if they're just going to activate the Tameo, like, I don't, maybe we attack it and they keep acting. Yeah, I do, like, because it's just free extra cards in our bin. Yeah, in their bin, sorry. Let's just attack it, although I don't really want to kill it. You are setting as long as it's down. Like, as long as it never gets to three loyalty, I think we're golden. See, we can play Folio of Fancies, leave up Tail's End. We can leave up Didn't Say Please, or we can just play. We probably just play Ashiok. We'll give him a turn. We'll give him a turn, and then next turn we can hold up all these. You know, we can hold up this counter magic here. Although, actually, we don't have very many blue sources, do we? All right. Exile in their graveyard as well is pretty strong. Ooh, what is this nonsense? Is this Reanimator? Are they playing Reanimator? Oh my goodness, it really is just five color nonsense here. Okay, so no Kenrith, but they can play the... Oh no, they can play the Fires into the Kenrith. Yeah, that's pretty strong, actually. Maybe I shouldn't have... Oh, an Ooze. Okay, maybe I should have countered Fires of Invention. Fires of Invention is pretty strong in their deck, because then they've got just infinite Kenrith activations. They didn't activate Tameo. They didn't activate Tameo. They saw through it. All right, well, I'm definitely going to keep up Tail's End. I'm definitely going to keep up Tail's End. So let's cast Folio of Fancies. And this gives us something to do if they don't play anything. Because, yeah, I don't really want to let the Tameo, the Kenrith resolve. Mill them another four. I feel like our Ashiok is going to bite the dust next turn, unfortunately. And no attacks. Yeah, they have to attack both Oozes at Ashiok here, which I think is what they'll probably do. Yep. Okay, well, no point blocking, because we lose Ashiok either way, no blocks. Yeah, I really feel like I should have... I really, really should have countered that Fire's Invention. All right, let's have a look, see what they're going to do now. Outlaw's Merriment. Jeez, that thing's going to kill us too. Sure. And now Kenrith. Our opponent has shown to be a... No, okay, never mind. I was going to say a little conservative with some of the things that they've done, but no, we got the Kenrith out of the... Well, I was going to say out of the hand, but we got it back into the command zone for two extra mana. Outlaw's Merriment. I'm not feeling good about this one. I have to be honest with you. I'm not feeling good about this one. Tammy upstairs? Yeah! Love it. Okay, what are they on? 31. All right, halfway there. Whoa, halfway there. So we can't activate the Folio, unfortunately. Let's see what they name. Liliana. They did not hit Liliana. Okay. Okay, and then, yeah. Ooze picks up. Interesting they didn't make a token there. Okay, we can play other Ashiok. Play other Ashiok, bounce the Ooze token. I guess they'll just make another one, though. We can make 2/3, start blocking. Our opponent's going to start giving us lip, are they? All right. If we play Ashiok, we can block this. Also blocks as well, protects itself. They'll make another ooze, but that's fine. We can block it. I think we play this Ashiok. I'm not 100% sure of what I should be doing in this situation. Let's play this Ashiok and see how it goes. They can't cast the Kenrith next turn, which is good. Right, let's make a 2/3. And activate this for 0. Because obviously we're not activating for anything else, and that means we get that sweet F6 value. Okay. Oh, they also get add the Outlaw's Merriment thing, don't they? Yeah, this is bad. Alright, no attacks. Okay. Alright. We're kind of getting wrecked here. Ritual of Soot would be good. Ritual of Soot would be very good. Ugh. Okay, and shocking themselves. Either a power move or they've got something scary. What are they on? 24. This takes 6 off. Oh, a Brokos. Oh no, with trample. Oh dear. Okay. Was that in the bin as well? I mean, I should have paid attention to that. If that were in the bin, mate, Riley, why are you so bad? And an Ember Cleave. Okay, sure. Seek and find. Oh dear, this is not going well. Luminous, and they hit the Luminous Broodmoth. Oh no. Okay, yeah. No, I'm going to take a stack here. I'm going to take a whole bunch. So we'll trade these off. I mean, what do we do here, right? They exile 2, yep. It takes so much damage. 18... Go to 3. Ooh dear. Alright. So I guess we... They can just re-equip the Embercleave is the problem. Yeah, I don't think we can do anything about that. Because we can bounce this. Bounce the Embercleave. That has trample. It has trample anyway, so if we bounce it, we can leave up. Didn't say please, but then they just put the Ember Cleave on the nothing. That attacks for 5. We can put that attacks for 10, and we can put 8. Maybe it's fine. All right, so we bounce the Brokos. I don't know if this is going to work or not, but I'm gonna try. So bounce that. We're a blue source short here. You're an 18. Because we can, yeah, we're because otherwise we can say we could leave up the didn't say please. We need this body down is the problem, right? All right. Let's draw a card. No, that's not what I wanted. Alright, I don't think this is going to work. I think we're probably dead. So mill them out for 6. And because they can just mutate Brokos and then attach the Embercleave. So we need them to miss that line, but I don't think they're going to. And I think we're just toast. Like, they just attach the Emberclave. Oh, actually, with the 2-1, we're just dead anyway, aren't we? Because it attacks for 12. Oh, it's not 10, it's 12 as well. Man, okay, I was just totally out of it. Yeah, no, I was 1,000% wrong here. They can mutate the Brokkos. Luminous Broodmoth. Yeah, I mean, yeah. Just dead. 8 cards, man. 8 cards. We were close. And then Kenrith as well. Give everything trample and haste. No, I was just 1,000 times dead. 1,000 times dead. One more turn would have done it. One more turn would have done it. We just cast Sweet Oblivion. No, not even that. Even that's not enough, actually. Because that does 4. The storied past holds our future. And, yeah, sweet. No blocks. All right, so that does 4, 6. No. All right. Never mind. You can't win them all. All right. All righty. Let's keep going here. Oops. Fiddling with a bread tie today. I like to fiddle with lots of different things. Eraser, that's good. Doesn't usually make too much noise when I drop it. My comb as well. Fans of my stream will know that I'm always fiddling with a comb. And a bread tie is the new technology today. this hand seems fine. Yeah, it seems fine. Ooh, playing against the 3-drop Kaya. Interesting. Okay. Van Cleef with the Kaya Orzhov Usurper. I haven't seen a lot of Kaya in Brawl. Kaya Bane of the Dead, I guess, is just like not remotely playable. Very good limited, but not going to get it done in Brawl or Constructed. Okay, must be a tough Mulligan decision for our opponent here. Makes it very hard to record videos like this when your opponent just hits the rope on the old Mulligan decision. Because I just have to sit here and spin the wheels and hope that something happens at some point that I can make some kind of relevant commentary about. Yep, cool. Well, I'm at a loss. We're going to fetch a swamp with this. I like this hand. It's not great, but it's fine. It's fine. We can Sweet Oblivion them. Obviously, Drowned Secrets would supercharge this, of course. Okay, and I wonder if our opponent had a... Now I'm going to get an island because we got that Jace we want to cast. Wonder if our opponent had a tough decision there, if they were just maybe AFK. Let's see. Okay, so let's just Sweet Oblivion them. Okay, that's a good hit. That's a good hit. Don't have to worry about that. Bounty Agent is not very good in this matchup. I like Bounty Agent. You should play it in your Brawl decks, but it is bad against Planeswalker Commanders. Alright, so... I'm going to exile the Sweet Oblivion. Very nice. Okay. We're not going to get to escape that one. No, exiling cards from their own graveyard to gain life. Well, that will not prove to be an effective tactic, I would imagine. Because we are not going to try to... they can gain as much life as they want. All right, what do we hit here? Let's have a look here. Okay, surely there's more than that. Yeah, all right. Soulmend of Raska's Finisher? This is not a card I've seen for a long time. Alright, okay. Interesting deck from our opponent. I wonder what its game plan is. I like the fact that there's no pressure, because now next turn we can probably play Jace. If they play to the board, we'll just play Mindrak Harpy. Child of Night, you say. Child of Night. Okay. So Yeah. We're still going to play. I'm going to sacrifice to kill the Ashiok. All right, that's fine. So we'll just play our Jace next turn. I mean, that's just a Stone Cold 2-for-1, so I'm not unhappy about that. And now they're just going to exile cards from their own graveyard to gain life. Because they can exile the... all right, sweet. Getting rid of our Sweet Oblivion there. That's fine. So now we can just cast Jace. I like this. I like the fact that we're just not under any pressure at all. Alright, so target them, they mill 2. We draw a card. Next time we've got Ashiok back online. Kaya is not going to do... We've got 2. Nah, I'm not that worried about Kaya killing us here. We don't have 1 drops. Oh, D-Spark, that's annoying. It's annoying for sure. So now the Kaya counts 3. I've got to make sure I don't lose to this Kaya ultimate here, so... I'll try to keep track of things. But just Ashiok next turn, I think, is going to be pretty good. What have they got in the bin? Why are they looking through the graveyard? Oh, they're exiling cards in the graveyard. Helping us along the way. Yeah, so we're going to cast Ashiok here. And then next turn, start leaving up counter magic. Like, there's no—it's no good leaving up counter magic in this spot because we don't have anything to protect. If they play, you know, a four drop or above here, then you know, fair dues. But I'd rather not hold these up when we've got nothing on the battlefield. We've already hit their Liliana, so they're not going to cast Liliana. The Dread Presence. Yeah, that's for sure annoying. That's for sure annoying. Okay, can ding us for three, but that doesn't really do anything. Yeah, I mean, Dread Presence is a good card for them to have hit. It puts a lot of pressure on. Oop, never mind. We've got the answer. So this is an instant. So let's just kill this now. We could have waited, but if they've got a swamp, it's just two free damage or a free card for them. So I think just price it. Ooh, yes, please. Yeah, Spark Double absolutely get a second Ashiok going. Are you kidding me? You'd love to see that. All right, now she got all the graveyard away. Yeah, great. All right, so this does mean two more cards in exile to the Kaya. But we're on 25. They're on 28 cards. Okay. Yeah, and that's not much pressure, I guess. That's fine. We got to 30, we get a Spark Double, make another Ashiok, start milling 8 cards a turn. We've got Disdainful Strike Negate up, we've got Mindwreck Harpy. Oh, mate, this mills him for 3 straight away. How much have we got? 6. So we could play this and then keep up. Yeah, we'll just do that. I mean, they're not going to cast something into both Disdainful Strike and Negate, so that's fine. So we won't cast this, we'll cast the Spark Double. Old Spark Doodlay here. I mean, that's a weird way to tap my mana, but sure, I guess it's fine. So Spark Double. Oh no, if they can kill the Ashiok in response, no, thank goodness. So Ashiok down and another Ashiok. Man, they are doing some work today. Ooh, Ethereal Absolution. Man, Orzhov has such sweet cards. It's weird because like I'm a rusted on green mage, but easily my favorite guild is Orzhov. Okay, and Teo, some other nonsense as well. We got another weird white card that was at the back there. Teo's Light Shield, okay. Seems like just a War of the Spark theme deck at the moment. Is it all War of the Spark cards? Not every single one, but a lot of them are. Yeah, there's a lot of War of the Spark cards in this list. All right. Sure. Take 5. Yep. And the Ajani's Pride Mate. And they can kill our Ashiok. That's fine. We'll just cast them again next turn. How many cards? 19. We're milling 8 a turn. And they gain one for... Oh, the Pride Mate is actually getting kind of large and in charge here. Hey. So, 7 mana for the Ashiok. Does not leave up Negate or Disdainful Stroke. We lose this Ashiok next turn. So maybe we just cast this and block. It's pretty bad. We lose this Ashiok. Oh, mate, I didn't follow my own lesson. You always do that last. And if I'm going to cast the Mindwreck Harpy here, then I've just wrecked it. I'm going to leave them with 3 cards in their bin to use. 15. Cast this. Maybe do we just cast that? No, because we can cast that next turn and leave up something. Yeah. All right. That's definitely not how I want you to tap my mana, please. Yeah, much better. Thank you. I guess I could have. No, I want to leave up. I'd rather leave up. I'm not activating Castle Lock. Fine. I'd rather leave up the two counter spells here. Yeah, great. So pay 5. I'll just negate that. I mean, they've been sitting on 2 cards in hand for so long. They must have been holding on to removal there. All right. So mill 3. They're on 11. So, hang on. Mortifying. All right. Sure. So we lose the Ashiok. Cast another one. Yeah. They go to 7. Then the Ashiok dies again. We need a little bit of extra help here. We need a bit of extra help. Yeah, sure. We need like a Wall of Lost Thought or something. Because now we get 1 activation from Ashiok. Okay, bravely not playing around removal spells there. And, ooh, Cry of the Carnarium does nothing. So we'll just play this. 19. Ashok at least is gaining a ton of life. So we got a 7. We can cast Ashok again next turn. So if there's any way for us to mill, what? 2 more cards? If we get Overwhelmed Apprentice or the stupid 0-4 would do it as well. Gideon, alright. And they've dodged this Disdainful Stroke pretty well. So 6 cards left. We are unfortunately on a 2-turn clock if they go upstairs. But I think they have to kill the Ashiok here. Prepare for battle. Is it 2 turns? No, not quite. Yeah, alright. So kill the Ashiok again. It's poor old Ashiok, mate. They are jumping in and out of this command zone. Right, 44. Thought Erasure does Stone Cold nothing. They're on 6. I mean, yeah. 9 mana Ashiok. Oops, I didn't. I tried to target their library. Alright. Man, main deck disenchant as well. Single combat. It's quite a brute. Alright, so 1 card left. So if they attack upstairs, they can. So we're gonna take 10. All right, it just comes down to like the top of our library here. Ugin. Either we find a card that can mill out this last card. My plans do not include you. And we do have a rebuy. We've got Castle Lochthwain. So we take 14. Go to 4. Or maybe even 15. Do we have a creature in the bin? No. Okay. So we take 14. We go to 4. And we need any card that gets them to draw. Like Folly of Fancies would do it. Merfolk Secret Keeper does it. Overwhelmed Apprentice does it. Wall of Lost Thoughts does it. Didn't say please doesn't, I don't think. Because I think we can... Unless it's target opponent. It's like... Counter target spell, target opponent. I don't think that's it. Oh, hang on. Are we dead? Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, the Kaya ultimate for the win. Oh, I completely forgot about that. Oh, that's so brutal. Again, just 1 turn short. Oh, mate. What a way to go. What a way to go. They had 1 card in their library. 1 card. Oh, mate. All right, we've got time for one more here, I think. Against Sorin, another Orzhov deck. All right. Just hope that it's not too much... hope they don't have too much pressure for us here. I think we'll keep this. It's not a very exciting hand, but I think we'll keep it. Let's go this... Maybe we want an actual 2-drop, I don't know. I'm not going to cast Scheming Symmetry. Or maybe I just do, I don't know. Maybe I should have cast Scheming Symmetry turn 1 and got the... No, I'll just play... I'll play Ashiok. I'll do the fancy thing. We'll go Ashiok. Mill him out. And then we'll go Scheming Symmetry for Drowned Secrets. And mill over whatever they search for. Like, giving them a free Vampiric Tutor is just way too good. Like, they can go get, like, any card. No. You've got to have a way to break the symmetry. All right, Bastion of Remembrance. That's going to be a problem. That puts on quite a fair bit of pressure here. Okay, so we go Scheming Symmetry. Target us to Drown Secrets. And... I think I'll leave up Negate, actually. I was going to cast the Wall of Lost Thoughts, but I think I'll just leave up Negate, because they're almost certainly just going to play Sorin next turn. So, let's just mill over what they searched for. Yeah, and the Pride Mate, of course, yeah. Naturally. Yeah, and get rid of a Lurrus as well. Not the Lurrus is very good with our main deck graveyard hate. So, end turn. And next turn we can play the Wall of Lost Thoughts while leaving up the Negate, if they're not going to play into it. But I think, I mean, they just slam Sorin here, I think. Yeah. Oh, Luminous Broodmoth instead. Okay. Well, that's actual pressure, which is a little annoying. But now we can go Drown Secrets. I think we do still leave up Negate. We lose Ashiok, but that's fine. I mean, it's not fine. I'd obviously rather that didn't happen, but what are we going to do? Like, I'm not going to play it. The wall doesn't prevent that. And stopping Sorin from coming down, I think, is going to be important too. My best answer. Yeah, negate. Couldn't negate that fast enough. So mill them for two. What are they on? 33. Rid of that. So away goes Ashiok. We can just cast Ashiok again next turn, though. That's fine. Although them having a board presence is just, it's like, this is the thing, you know, we need removal spells. You've seen the difference in, like, when we played Mono Green and we were able to keep the board clear versus this one where we can't. Like, we just play Ashiok and it just dies straight away. It's extremely bad. This is like, mill you for six, gain four life. I guess if I don't activate Ashiok, then they don't die, but then what are we even doing at that point? 26. Liliana will be good, admittedly. Liliana will be good. If they don't play another creature here, Impassioned Orator, this, all right. So now Liliana is a lot less good. Although Cry could... Ooh. Okay. Deal. Absolutely. You love to see it. So now we can Cry... cast the wall, mill them for 10. And, I mean, I'm pretty sure if we play Liliana and sacrifice two creatures, and if they have a non-flying creature, I'm pretty sure they get it back with the Luminous Broodmoth, but I'm not 100% sure of that. I guess we can do some science next turn to find out. What are they on now? It's 15, so they're getting towards the danger zone here. Right, 5 mana, what's this going to be? God Eternal Aketra, maybe? Cavalier of Night. Yeah, I wonder if they're going to get it back. If we draw a land and play Liliana, maybe we just cast Ashiok. We've milled out and then exiled all their good creatures, so this Ashiok doesn't really do anything. They seem determined to ignore the... ignore our Ashiok, though. I kind of want to play this Ashiok for multiple reasons. Like, we draw a card off it. It mills them for two, whereas Liliana doesn't. Yeah. Yep. I'm going to do this. Mill them. This mills for eight total. Draw a card. And then we both mill two. And now exile your graveyard down to 7. Yeah. They can't really ignore the Ashioks now. Like, between them, that's 6 cards. And then this is another 4. What are they on? 6? Yeah, all right. So they actually have to attack the Ashioks this turn. Well, they have to attack Ashiok Dreamrender with the Broodmoth. Otherwise they just die. But I think we got them, right? They're on 6. We can just cast this. We've got enough. Yeah, I think we got him. I think we're gonna win this one. Because as long as they don't destroy the Drowned Secrets, they've got 6 cards. They can't kill both of these. What are they doing? Okay. They can't kill both of these. This is either 4 or 2, and then this by itself is another 4 cards. So I think we're fine. We're on 16. Yeah. I'm not saying it's possible, because I've lost some games that I really, like, a lot of people look at me, geez, this is an unlosable game, and I've lost some games like that, but I don't know what could happen to make us lose this game. Certainly our opponent going after us instead of the lethal onboard Ashiok is one thing. Oh, mate, triple Ashiok? Win the game with triple Ashiok? Yeah, mate, absolutely. Look at this. So triple Ashiok. Oh, my goodness. More Ashioks than anyone could handle. Mill you for two. Mill you for two. And then to finish things off, my final trick. This Ashiok departs for greener pastures. No, for bluer and blacker pastures here. downstairs to mill out their final couple of cards. All right, we got there. We got there. All right. Won't even activate this, Ashiok. Don't even worry about it. Don't even need to. All right, beautiful. That, my friends, is how you do it. 3 Ashioks on the battlefield. Easy game. Well, there you have it. While I don't think anyone is going to, you know, hope to claim this is the most powerful Brawl deck, it definitely is one of the sweetest I've played. And in certain situations, I mean, there's a lot of dirtling. There's a lot of dirtling in Brawl, and this is a good way to punish it. I think it just needs more removal, to be honest. We actually didn't see Sir Conrad. That was a card that I forgot to mention earlier. Sir Conrad can just kill them with actual damage because you mill over like 4 creatures and they take 4 or whatever. But I don't know. Like, I'm less convinced about Folio of Fancies and cards like that. Even Mindrak Harpy. The fact that we don't play many creatures, I think is very strong because it blanks the removal. But then again, I don't know. We are playing, I guess, enough creatures for it to matter. I'm not sure. Anyway, probably a little more removal if I would adjust it in one way, a little more removal. Maybe, you know, getting rid of some of these cards that we don't really need. Stuff like the Folio of Fancies. Maybe the Gadwick. Just to put more cards that actually, you know, defend our core game plan, which is just getting them out and milling them out. Anyway, that is that for another episode of Channel Fire Brawl. I hope you've enjoyed yourself. I hope you've had a good time. I certainly love making these dumb videos. So if you've got a list that you'd like to send in and have featured on this show, please do. The best place to do that, of course, is on my Discord. If you go to bit.ly/joinRileysDiscord. You'll be able to find the decklist submission channel there, and you can send me through Brawl lists, or on Twitter, twitter.com/RileyGreetow. And if you want to check out this list I've posted publicly, you can go and find it at bit.ly/AshiokBrawl. But that's that for another episode of Channel Fire Brawl. Thanks very much for hanging out with me. Hope you enjoyed yourselves. It's been a lot of fun. And take care of yourselves. I'll see you next time.